Now we are going to discuss about the interview questions which I faced while attending with Mr. Nambi. Okay, shall we start this discussion?
Yeah.
Okay. So actually, first, yeah, I've seen my resume. In that, we know our resume, right? We have shown our both the areas. I mean, verification area and design area. We worked on both the things, right? So during that time, also we were worked in wireless USB project. So I was involved in RTL design, right? So he has seen the full resume. After that, he asked me in which area you are feeling so strong. So I told that right now I am in RTL design. So I feel quite comfortable with RTL design, like that I told. Okay. So he asked questions from that RTL design point of view. Okay. So this is all about that intro of this interview. Then he asked the questions from that RTL design. Okay, shall we start those questions?
Yes.
First question is, when you will infer a latch? This is what that first question.
So what I think that when we can infer a latch means, you take example of if else statement. So if we have only mentioned the if part and we have not mentioned the else part, okay. Or you can say that when we are not assigning the output to some known state during the execution of always block, in that case you will infer the latches. Or you can take a case example of case statement. If you have not assigned the value of output to all the known state, so in that case you will infer a latch. Yeah. So these are the some possible means reasons, scenarios where we can have some unwanted latches.
Right. So in relog code, when we will infer a latch? Can you tell me? If you are intentionally writing latch,
we'll infer. Okay. Right.
When we'll get unwanted latches?
Suppose we are, you take example of always and if we part you mention, but don't mention the else part.
Okay. For example, my construct is like this. If select.
Okay.
Right? And y is equal to?
A.
Okay.
Right.
And I'm mentioning select and A as my sensitivity list. Okay.
Okay.
Now, here I have not mentioned that else part. Else part I have not mentioned, right?
Right. You have not mentioned else part.
So, what we'll infer?
So, if else part is not mentioned means, if select is 0, in that case, you are not assigning the value of output to some known state, right?
Yeah.
So, in that case, it will maintain, it will recall its previous value.
Yeah.
So, that is the...
So, for that, it needs some storage elements, right?
Right.
So, for that, it will infer a latch.
Latch, feedback.
Okay. So, this is one scenario. And can you tell me one more scenario?
You take an example of case statement here. Suppose case statement
okay.
is 2-bit. Okay. And you have not mentioned all the 4 state for these 2 bits.
Okay. Suppose I am using only these two things.
Yeah. So, suppose select is coming as 1-0. Okay. In that case, what value it will take? It
for
can't take any value, right?
Yeah.
So, it will for 1-0 as well as for 0-1, you will get, it will maintain its previous state.
Right. So, if we don't mention some particular combination, then for that we will infer a latch because it has to maintain some value, right?
Yeah.
So, by default, it will take the previous value. For that, we will infer a latch. So, these are all the two scenarios we will infer a latch.
Okay.
Right? Okay. Then, the question is, if you infer an unwanted latch, will it affect your design?
Yeah, it will affect our design. We are expecting combination circuit, but
right.
we are getting the functionality of sequential means. In that case, definitely our property will change.
Suppose we are using combinational circuit to drive the some other logic, okay, some other modules. In that case, as soon as that there is a change in select, it will go to this if-else construct. Suppose our select is XX.
Okay.
In that case also it should execute else part, right?
Right.
So actually we have not mentioned else part. For that it has to retain the hold value.
Right.
So during that improper input condition also our circuit will work.
Right, right.
So actually it will leads to some malfunction, right? So unwanted latches actually most of the times will create some problems, right?
Yeah. Even this is a feedback loop, a combination feedback loop. So in that case, it is difficult to constrain that. We have to break this thing in synthesis.
Okay.
Then only we can constrain the path.
Okay.